heart was buried alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I got a feeling. I am alive, there must be a reason. I was given one more chance, my heart still beating.
Move into your imaginations.
Do you know if you never move into the consciousness of your imagination or your wish being fulfilled, you may think you're stuck, when all that's really required is for you to move into the consciousness.
Those of you who are wishing bad for people, stop it. I'm going to tell you why, because this verse, God revealed something to me. It blew my mind. Be careful of what you're wishing for people, because what you're wishing for people could be the very thing that comes right back and hits you in the face.
When I woke up this morning, beloved, I heard the Lord say so strongly, tend to your own garden in this hour. The word for you today is tend to your own garden. Do not look to the right nor to the left, but water your own grass. Water your own lawn. What do I mean? I mean that spiritually, mentally, emotionally, creatively, business-wise, whatever it is in life, tend to your own garden, because the enemy is going to try to distract you and get you to look to the right and to the left and at everybody else's yard, everybody else's grass. But see, the thing you got to know and understand is, see, when other people's grass is green, you don't know what they're doing to maintain that grass. You don't know what they're doing to keep that grass green. And a lot of times, it's not even really green. It's fake. It ain't even real grass, meaning it's not what you think it is on the surface. What lies right below the color is artificial, fake stuff. Fabricated stuff. Moral of the story, don't get distracted by comparing yourself to other people's situations and circumstances, relationships, marriages, whatever that may be, because you don't know what's going on behind closed doors. You don't know what's really going on below the soil of the grass. So tend to your own yard and garden, beloved. Do not get distracted, because you don't want to miss what God is trying to grow and build and develop and what seeds he's trying to plant in your yard.
They didn't know who you were and who you are. They do now. Oh, they do now. God's favor is literally shining so bright upon you. Everyone sees the heavenly glow that you have on your life. Everyone sees the light that literally shines down like the sun itself on your life. And they're like, dang. Yeah, they messed up. They messed up when they thought that they can treat you like you were regular. They messed up when they thought they can treat you like you were anybody. They messed up. Yeah. They messed up. They slept on you. But God says, arise and shine, for your light has come. And God is getting ready to do something so amazing in your life that they won't have no doubt of who you are ever again. And now that you saw the room, you know the room. And you know who to avoid in the room and who to invite to your table. They can't sit here. They can't sit with you. You're gonna shine.
Be mindful of the people that go quiet once you start doing something that is working towards your purpose. When you were struggling, when you couldn't figure it out, when the relationship was failing, when things just didn't make sense, they were all ears. They're supporting you. But when the tables have turned and you're doing better and you're in a better place mentally, physically, financially, they're nowhere to be found. They don't pick up your calls anymore. Be mindful of those people.
I'm different. I always have been. And it took me a while to accept that I am not a magic meant for everyone to understand. So they question it. But that's okay. I'll stay in my lane, being all magical and shit.
Hi, Bride of Christ. I know y'all have been receiving a lot of spiritual warfare, and even more so now than ever, because we are so close to our time of being delivered and going home to be with our bridegroom forever. My whole life has brought me to this moment in time. God has chosen me to bring this message to the body of Christ because he knew that I would obey and that I would listen, and no matter what it would cost me, I would take it to the people and feed it to them. Jesus loves his bride. He would never hand her over to Satan because we are his. And the ones that fully know that, they feel in their hearts right now that it's time to go home. I want you guys to know, I am fully aware that I am responsible for every single person that watches my videos. I am responsible for what I say on this platform. and who it affects on this platform. That alone would put the fear of God into anybody. If I was not sure of what God has spoken to me, I wouldn't say it. I do want to read you guys some scriptures that will uplift you today. This is Hebrews 10. Cast not away, therefore, your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he that shall come, and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith, but if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. But we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. It is a very scary thing to walk by faith and not by sight. But doing so, God can clearly see that we trust him fully. We are not afraid for what is to come, because all of this evil that's going to come on the earth isn't for us. That is why we are rejoicing right now. We could even be taken today for all I know. But how wonderful is it to think we are all going to be sitting together, feasting with the King of Kings, with all of our brothers and sisters that completely put all of their trust in Jesus Christ. What a beautiful and glorious thing that is, to know that we will never be suffering anymore. Jesus Christ forever. Walk by faith and not by sight, because that's where you'll find Jesus Christ.
So God gave me the name Nehemiah, and when I looked up the name Nehemiah, it means comforted by God. And from there, the Lord is saying that many in this hour is going to be experiencing God's supernatural peace. Many of us were battling storms, calamities, afflictions, adversity. Many of us was really going through it in this season to get to the promised land. So now God is going to bless us with more and more spiritual wealth. We're going to be comforted by God. We're going to experience the peace. We're going to experience that sense of ease regardless of what is going on around us. All of the worry, all of the stress, all of the anxiousness, all of the frustration is going to be replaced with love, with peace, with joy, with prosperity, abundance. So in this season, the name has changed. Nehemiah, God's comfort.
Thank you to every enemy that ever fought me. Because you taught me when you fought me that I was gifted. I didn't think I was worth being fought till you fought me. You taught me that I was gifted. I didn't understand what you was talking about at first. You got to learn how to appreciate the people who resisted you, who went to war against you, who scandalized your name and attacked you. If you didn't have something, they wouldn't attack you. There's a reason bag ladies can walk up and down the street and don't nobody mug them. They don't have anything worth stealing. If the enemy is trying to mug you, it's a sign you got something valuable. It's time for you to know it for yourself. This is hard to get over because some of you have been beat down so long. When a positive word comes along, you don't know how to receive it. But if I'm preaching right, holler at me and say, I'm gifted.
I hear the Spirit of God saying that you are enough. You are more than enough. You are more than a conqueror. Before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. I had a plan for you, declares the Lord. Everything that you go through is for divine destiny. Everything that you go through is taking you to a new level. Do not get discouraged. Do not grow weary. Do not give up, because the Lord is with you. Keep on fighting, keep on pressing, keep on persevering, because the Lord is not going to let you down.
Steady focus. I know that we are warring right now for a lot of things. There's a lot of things the enemy is fighting. He's fighting every single thing about our calling, our ministry, and our kingdom. And we're bringing in the kingdom. It's not about just kingdom spouse stuff. It's not about just our families. It's not just about generational curses. It's about all of it. And all of it is being attacked. We're being attacked. It gets mental. It gets financial. It gets on your body sometimes. It gets everywhere. It gets all over you. But here we know that the blood of Jesus covers us in all of those things. And as long as we stay steady, focused on him, and we don't start looking to the left at this warfare, like where's it coming from, or like what's going on, and start trying to dissect it, and over here and over here, don't look to the left or to the right, look at Jesus. Stay steady, aim, focus on Jesus, and you will not go wrong. Because in those moments when you're too weak, he fights your battles for you. And even when you're not too weak, he will still have you step aside and fight certain battles for you. He is always fighting for you, and next to you, inside of you, beside you, all around you. Your angels are all around you fighting for you. You don't have any reason to look off to any side at any point and try to figure out why this person's doing this, and why this person won't do this, and why this is happening, why my kids being attacked, why is my family doing this, why is happening over here, why is my mind blah blah blah. It's all of that is distracting. We know that Jesus is fighting for us, and if we keep our steady focus on him, he's going to bring us through all of it. But it's not about looking at this thing over here and going, how do I get it? Or looking at, how do I get money over here? Or how do I do this over here? It's about keeping your eyes on Jesus and letting him aim you. Letting him aim your focus to where it's supposed to be directed. Because the enemy is trying to attack you in any way that he can to get you to go left and to go right. But, glory be to God, he makes our way straight. He makes our path straight if we just follow him. Because if we start looking over here, swerving over here with fears, with doubts, with excitement, with whatever it is, I'm not talking about good excitement, but even good excitement can be bad if it's distracting you. But I'm talking about like swerving back and forth between these emotions that we have and this attack that's going on and everything that's coming in or going out. Like if we're constantly swerving back and forth, our way is not straight. It may look like things are curvy, but if we focus on Jesus, he said he makes our path straight. A steady aim, focus on him will get you to exactly where you're supposed to be. You don't have to worry about when's your kingdom spouse coming. You don't have to worry about when's the money coming. You don't have to worry about where you're going to lay your head tonight. You don't have to worry about anything going on in your peripherals, because Jesus covers your peripherals, your back, your front, your every side of you. He knows exactly what he's doing. You just have to stay focused on him, because if you can't listen, if you don't listen to the direction he's giving you, you're not going to know the path to take. It's not going to be a straight path. It's going to go sideways in every other way. But it says 1,000 at your right hand fall and 1,000 at your left hand fall, because Jesus is king and you focus on him.
I want to share a scripture with you that changed my life as a wife. When I ran across this scripture, it shook me. It shook me to my core. And it led me to self-reflect and change my outlook and behavior in my marriage as a wife. Proverbs 14:1, every wise woman buildeth her house, but the foolish plucketh it down with her hands. If I had not run across this scripture and it cut me deeply, I'm not sure that I would still be married today. Thank the Lord for his word and how it cuts, because I am happily married today. We cannot change other people's behavior. We can only change our own. And by doing that, our spouses, our loved ones, will see that and want to change their behavior to fit ours. So I wanted to share that with you, because that is a scripture that I will never forget, and I can tell you has blessed me in my life and my marriage. In Jesus' name.
Baby, folks be so mad when they don't like you and you don't even pay them no mind. It's like, listen, you don't like me. That's a personal issue. You got to go ahead and deal with that within yourself. But you think I'm finna entertain you and your thoughts because you took the time out of your day, your unbusy day, to dislike me? I don't care nothing about it. I don't care. That's on you. If you decide to continue to waste your time and energy on little old me, I am flattered. Because as busy as my day is, I didn't even notice you. I didn't even notice you until you made me notice you. And then I didn't even notice you anymore because I don't keep my eyes focused on foolishness and foolish people. So you disliking me is a personal issue that you personally have to get over and you will personally be okay. You are so focused and so deep into your work, so deep into your purpose, you ain't even gonna notice them no way. Cause while they still down there with their low-minded, low-thinking self, you gonna be elevating and leaving them to their stinking thinking. Let them have it. You ain't gotta prove yourself to none of them. They ain't gonna believe it no way. They wanna believe the negative about you because it's something within they self that's so negative that they don't believe that they're worthy or deserving of good things. So they're not gonna believe that you do. They're not gonna believe that you should have what you have, but you ain't got none of that for them no ways. So let them run their mouth. Let them do what they doing. Talk is cheap. Talk is cheap. Let people have that little bit. Let them keep looking at your fabulous self. They mugging because they smell they self. That's just how I put it. But to sit up there and to go back and forth with somebody that don't like me but doing the most to keep up with me, I refuse. Because I got business to take care of. And if they had as much business to take care of, they wouldn't even notice my black behind anyway.
There are three basic rules to life. Don't promise when you're happy. Don't reply when you're angry. And don't decide when you're sad.
Blessings, beautiful kings and family. So I really wanted to share this with you. Something happened tonight that made me want to share this with you guys, especially to my sisters in Christ. There is no reason that you need to compromise your worth. There's no reason that you need to beg someone to appreciate you, to see you for who you are. There is no reason that you need to beg someone for their attention, to treat you the way that you deserve to be treated. Somewhere there is someone out there that the Lord has designed perfectly for you, who is going to be the head of your household, who you're going to be their rib. I know in a time where relationships are very casual and we're trying to be set apart and holy and pure and really, you know, uphold the Lord's word, it can be so easy to want to fall into temptation or to do what other people do. But you have to remember that we are not like everybody else. We are called to be holy, set apart. We are supposed to be God's chosen remnant. But sisters, I just want you to understand that you are so valuable to the Lord, and the right person that the Lord has for you will see your worth, will understand that you are the daughter of the Most High God, and will treat you accordingly. He will not treat you like something that can be replaced or someone that can be replaced. He will treat you like what you are. Stay blessed, stay encouraged, and most importantly, stay in the Word.
Perfected Faces Makeup Artist Candy. Spontaneity is magic. Imperfection is beauty. Flaws are underrated. Beauty is so subjective. The most beautiful things in life are simple yet wholesome. The idea of beauty, I believe, got eroded gradually thanks to media and pop culture. What was once beautiful is now called shabby minus. Unkempt hair, freckled face, fat thighs, hairy legs and armpits, stretch marks and cellulite. When the models on the billboards and magazines are just like you and I, behind those numerous filters, we deem to be perfect. Perfected faces makeup artist Candy come see.